Today, we are continuing the project of Mod Review, and the focus is on UI and AI improvement. So we'll review extra menus and elements which will help you govern the colony more efficiently, and we'll make pawns cleverer and better suited for survival in the harsh RimWorld. The first mod on the list is Allow tool. It gives you a lot of extra options to control which items do you forbid, unforbid, select or haul, as well as giving you a bunch of other tools such as ability to harvest all ripe plants, haul everything, rearm all traps and even select similar things on the whole map, which means that you can achieve the same results with much less amount of clicks. It integrates with the game naturally. For example, I can click on the stone, select similar and then select multiple stones of the same type. And there is also functionality which is not immediately visible, but it is there. Normally it's the equals key, which is to the left of the backspace. For example, I can select mine and click on an ore, and now if I click this context action, it will select all the ore adjacent to it. Let me show it again. So I'm mining one of the tiles and I'm clicking equals to the left of the backspace, and that does that. Similarly, I can select this specific order, click this key, and to cancel this kind of order on the whole map. You wouldn't know about it if you just installed it, so I wanted to share this with you. Another option which I really like is Haul Plus. If you really need something hauled, you can use Haul Urgent Delivery instead of Haul. And as you can see in the warp type, it can be set quite high, above basic, which means that you have a much better control if you really need something moved. All these tools can be enabled or disabled in the mod settings, so if you only need one or two of them, you can tick the rest off so they don't clutter your interface. The mod requires Hugsleep. The automatic Night Owl mod will automatically plan a proper time schedule for your pawns with Night Owl traits. It is quite specific but very useful when you get multiple people joining and dying and joining again, so you do not have to automatically babysit every Night Owl. You can always come back to it and fix it later. With Build from Inventory mod, the pawns will be able to use things in the inventory for construction. They will only do it if there is nothing available elsewhere. If you are going on a raid and you want to build some sandbags, you don't have to drop your steel anymore. So this is a small mod, but it's quite useful, especially if you use other mods which allow you to force your pawns to pick up specific items. The Colony Groups mod is quite complex, but it adds a lot of flexibility to your ability to organize and control the colonists. At first, as you can see, it can show which weapons they have equipped under the portrait. And there is a specific default group called Colony. To the right of it, which I have currently hidden but you can make it visible, there is a button which you can press by selecting multiple colonists. That would put them in a different group. And if you click on a specific group and go to manage, you can actually add or remove specific colonists from this group. For example, let's say I wanted to have 2 soldiers, 3 farmers and 2 haulers. Let me do that. So at first, I select first 2 guys and I create a group. This group will be the first group. And in the manage options, I'm going to give it an icon. I think the shield will do. And I'm going to call it guards. Now I have a group called guards. Then the next 3 colonists will get into the group, which I move second, give it an icon, which looks like hand raising a plant, and I rename it to farmers. I don't need this third group, so I'm going to go to the manage and disband it. Okay, the last 2 will be my haulers, in which case I go to the manage, I replace the icon with something that looks like a workforce. For example, the sign of the wall will do because they will also be my constructors. So I will rename them to workers. Now I have 3 different groups which I can easily select, and also if I don't need a specific group right now, for example, they could be refugees joining. I can just right click and click this eye icon and they'll be gone from the hotbar. And later I can easily bring them back. The whole interface is adjustable. There's another icon which I hit, normally it's visible, but you can hide them all, which allows you to fine-tune and display various counters next to the colonists, as well as increase and decrease the size and the position of the bar. You can also move the weapon up and down, so you can make it look like they're holding it. You can disable color-coded mood bar, and this option disables the need of CM color-coded mood bar mod. You can disable the display of health and other needs. And you can completely hide the groups on the left. And in the future, if you go to the options, you can re-enable the groups again. So all of this is purely customizable, which allows you to fine-tune the groups to your liking. You might have already noticed, but I must show it again. The colony managed bar has a few options, such as diplomacy and wealth. And what's more important, each group also has a separate bar where you can set up policies and global time schedule. In addition to that, there is a button of orders where you can order the group to arrest everybody or execute all downed enemies or select mode of attack. The strongest, the weakest, or pursue fleeing. There's also a button to report to medical, which will send only the wounded to the medical ward. And you can select a couple of buttons which will force the rescue and tending of wounds. In general, all these buttons, such as taking combat drugs, are something that you can do manually, but because of the type of this mod, it is designed for a bigger fortress where you have dozens of colonists, so it does simplify the orders a lot. There's also battle positions button, because you can set the positions like this by simply selecting specific area and moving the colonists to their positions. And now, if you select four different types of battle stations, after you undraft the colonists, you still have a choice to go back to the same menu and click battle stations, and they'll take the same spots. And finally, the work tab allows you to manually prioritize specific work groups. You can even specify priorities here if you would like to. You can force the group to take a break, to go to eat or to sleep, and finally there is a button to send caravans. You can fully automate the whole colony management from this single menu. The mod requires the Harmony library. Have you ever been upset by the fact that you have so many things in architect tabs and you cannot remember them all, especially with all the mods? Well, there is a tool just for you, it's called Command Palette. This Command Palette mod allows you to have a right-click menus. At first, there is nothing, but as soon as you start typing, for example, chop, you get various commands right here. If I want to build a bed, I right-click and I type bed. And here we go, I can make a wooden bed. Also, it remembers what you picked, so if I made the bed, if I selected to chop wood, and I select to mine, all of these persist, and you just need to right click twice to get rid of this menu. It does complicate controls a bit, so if you are new to the game and especially if you don't know what you are looking for, this may be not for you, but if you have already played Rimworld for a while and you do know what you are actually looking for, this is a very quick way to find. For example, here I want to claim all these walls. And now I want to deconstruct them. Extremely simple, extremely fast. You don't need to click any extra items. A simple yet very useful mod is Don't Block Door. This supposedly simple mod forbids items from staying on the tiles with doors and can literally save your fort Only those who play the game would understand, but basically any item could disallow you from closing the door, and in this case the items will be pushed to the next tile, so the door can close normally. That could usually prevent your fridge from dropping below zero, or it could let an enemy into the base. Dubs Mint Minimap adds a fully functional minimap function to the game. It allows you to enable and disable specific types of pawns. You can even show terrain and enemies. For example, the predators have their own icons, and if a dangerous creature would enter the map, you would see that. It also allows you to click anywhere and go there very fast, so you don't have to scroll around like crazy. This is one of the mods which I usually play with all the time, and you can put it anywhere you like, so it doesn't obstruct your view. Drop Inventory mod gives another command which can be issued for the pawn to drop everything they're carrying in the inventory. It is especially useful with other mods which add functionality to carry stuff around in the inventory, which I list in this collection. Meals on Wheels is another addition to the inventory management mod list, and it allows your colonists to eat food from their inventory or even from the pack animals, so you don't have to drop the food on the ground. The Path Avoid mod allows you to set up specific routes which would direct colonists. For example, if I select a hate type of pathing and cover this area, the colonist will go around. This way you can make specified paths, alleys, or just try to make your colonists not go where they don't have to specifically. It is also quite useful if you want to create some walking paths and you don't want your colonists to cut corners. Look at this typical situation. Bunch of items laying around. So what if I want to hold them? Let me give the colonist an order. Please hold this medicine. Let's see what happens in the base game. She took the medicine. If I want her to hold now the metal, the medicine is on the ground, and another piece is being held. Let's look at the same situation with the mod Pick Up and Hold enabled. So I have given an order to hold the medicine, and this is what happens. All the items are collected and they are in the inventory. And this is where the mod Drop Inventory is also useful. This is great in combination with the other mods I mentioned today, which allow the pawns to use health items and food from the inventory. And in general, it does simplify the hauling quite a lot, because now everybody can carry more than one type of item at once. You can also give specific orders to pick up an item, and that will make this guy just keep it. And if he holds a rest, the item will stay. This is useful if you want your pawn to carry an extra item and then use it in the heat of battle or on another part of the map. Quality Builder adds an extra button to the furniture, which allows you to set up what kind of quality of an item do you want. If the wrong quality is picked, the item will be disassembled and rebuilt again. It will also limit the construction order to your best crafters. You can also pick the best builder or make it ignore construction skill above specific limit, so you don't have to wait for one guy only if you have a bunch of level 10 skill guys and you are okay with them building. This is useful if you want to have a bunch of pets and you don't want to micromanage just selecting and deconstructing them over and over. Replace Stuff is another quality of life mod for construction. It allows you to build something on top of already existing objects. The specific walls, for example, in this case will be deconstructed and rebuilt, so you don't have to manually wait for the deconstruction to happen and then build on top of that. It is very useful when you try to repurpose your base or make it bigger. Research Info is a very simple small mod. It gives a reason to click on Research Bench, because now you can see which project is being researched and the progress, as well as estimated time. Research Pile Forked is an improved version of Research Pile, which vastly improves the research screen. So in vanilla, you do have this screen with different tabs, and you can scroll left and right. You cannot really queue multiple things at once, and you cannot look for specific information. There is no search option. With the mod enabled, you do get this advanced screen where everything is spread around and organized, and you also have a search window. So if I want to look for hydroponics, I can find that. More than that, it also searches for the items which you can research. So for example, if I want to look up some kind of gun, you can see that this specific gunsmithing menu gives you a bunch of different recipes. And if you right-click them, you can actually see what kind of recipe it is. You can also queue your research by drag and dropping it on top, or by shift double-clicking. And then you can unqueue in the same manner. It's very intuitive, very simple, and I especially love the search option. Because now, if I forget what do I need to make something like lens, I can see that there is a charge lens in the pulse charge technology division. Very useful. The mod called Share the Load simply allows multiple phones to carry items to the same blueprint. So your constructions get finished and built much faster, and you don't have to wait until your single pawn drags that steel across the map 10 times. Smart Medicine mod is another mod to add to the list of inventory improvement mods. It allows pawns to use medicine from their inventory. In addition to that, there is a new button in the gear section where you can instruct the pawn to stock up on medicine or drugs and carry it around. So this way you can have real field doctors who would have medicine with them, and they would be able to use those medical herbs or medicine from inventory. The combat drugs can also assist you during the fight if you need to take them. Smart Speed mode adds the fifth speed, ultra fast, without developer mode. In addition to that, by right clicking you can set the event speed. So if you don't want to wait for your game to crawl because of some stupid event, you can ignore that feature and you don't have to wait for 10 minutes for a rabbit to be killed. Smarter construction improves pathfinding and tile selection when building big structures. This way your pawns will not get stuck as often. And last but not least, the Jobs of Opportunity mod simply improves vanilla hauling. The previous version of this mod was already integrated into vanilla as an ability to carry multiple items on the way, and now the selection should be even better. This mod also is patched to integrate with Pickup and Haul and other similar mods. If you like this kind of content, please leave a like and a comment if you would like to add something from yourself. I'm looking forward to build a community and create many more videos about RimWorld. I have a long list of mods to review, and I will be grateful if you could share your opinion. Thank you so much for watching, and I wish you a great day. See you in the next video. Bye bye.